So capsule endoscopy is the ability to image the small intestine using non-invasive means. The capsule endoscopy is a pill camera. It's a pill that's about the size of a large vitamin pill, and within that pill is a camera that takes pictures about two or three times per second. And a patient will swallow the capsule, or I will place it endoscopically, and it will allow us to have images of the small intestine, which is something that we cannot normally access from our current endoscopes. So. The capsule records for about 8 hours. When we perform our endoscopies, we can look from into the esophagus, into the stomach, and really about 10 to 15 centimeters into the small intestine from above. This enables us to, again, in a non-invasive fashion, to look for problems in the small intestine. This is the belt that the patient would wear. The images from the capsule are transmitted to this belt and then recorded on this device. This device then will record all the images and enable us to download the images to our computer system in order to read the study. This is an example of images that we would see with the small bowel capsule. This is a patient who had GI bleeding and has a number of ulcers found throughout her entire small intestine. These ulcers that we can see right here are evidence of damage in her intestinal wall, and this is something that could not otherwise be seen in this patient. We can place a capsule in a child as low as 10 kilograms, or about 20 pounds. Children who are too young to swallow, we can introduce the capsule in the course of an upper endoscopy to allow the capsule to go directly into the small intestine. This technology is a really, it's a better option for people of all ages. It's not a substitute for colonoscopy. It's not a substitute for an upper endoscopy. The reason it's not a substitute is because while it is diagnostic, because it's non-invasive, we cannot biopsy, so we cannot evaluate the tissue that we see. So it's merely a visual diagnosis. The other thing is that we can't intervene. So for example, were I to see a polyp that could be removed, I would not be able to remove it with the capsule, and so thus it would require, if I were to see a polyp on a colonoscopy, I would then go ahead and remove it because the scopes that we use have the capability to perform interventions such as removal of polyps. It's a useful technology that's going to, I think, help provide better care for our patients without being invasive.